Hello students, in this lesson let us study about the superannuation. So we'll see what is superannuation and also study the objectives and advantages of providing the superannuation. So normally we know that when there is a curve, horizontal curve, what we do, we just raise the outer rail over the inner rail, right? So this raised elevation is called as the super elevation. So the notation given to the super elevation is T. Okay. So the super elevation has other names like cant, banking. So the other names of super elevation E is what? Cant or banking. So truly speaking, what will happen? This term should be used to represent the angle of the transverse slope which we provide to the sleepers so that we pack the ballast under the outer edge. Okay, so the notation is E or SE. E or SE, as I told you. Now observe this figure. So this is your outer rail and this is your inner rail. So if you observe, there is a raise here, right? This raise is nothing but your super elevation, right? So this raise is nothing but your super elevation, Z angle. So this is your super elevation E. Now gauge distance is what? G is your gauge distance, right? Distance between two rails. So let us call this as G. So what is G? Gauge. Okay, I will take one more term. This inclined distance, I call it as S. So what is S? Length of inclined surface. So this angle, let us call this angle as theta. So according to this diagram, what is your tan theta? Tan theta is opposite by adjacent. Opposite is E, the adjacent. In this triangle, the adjacent is what? G. This is the G, horizontal distance. So what will be your E? G tan theta. So this is in terms of the gauge, right? If you want to write in terms of S, that is the length of inclined surface, which will you take? Opposite is there, hypotenuse is there. So sine theta. So sine theta is what? Opposite by hypotenuse. So what will be E? S sine theta. So once G is known, theta is known, you can find the value of the super elevation. Why we introduce super elevation? This is all about the definition and the way to calculate the super elevation. Now it is important for us to know why we introduce the super elevation in our structure, right? So we normally provide it in what surfaces? In your curved tracks, right? Why we do this is introduce the centripetal force to counteract the tendency of centrifugal force which is acting horizontally through the center of gravity, right? So what will happen is here, because this is moving in the curved surface, there will be a centrifugal force which is developed, right? In order to counteract this, we have to provide some centripetal force so that what will happen, this vehicle is pulled back onto the track and resulting increase in wheel load will be there on the outer rim. So this is the weight of the vehicle, this is the weight of the vehicle, so let us take it as W. This is the centripetal force P. So this will be what? Your resultant. If you see, it is acting in this particular direction. So when the amount of super elevation is in such a way that this, the resultant of your weight and the centripetal and the centrifugal force passes to the center of the track, it has to pass to the center of the track, then that super elevation is called as what? Your equilibrium super elevation or equilibrium cant. So what is equilibrium cant? Equilibrium super elevation or equilibrium cant. So when the resultant of W and P, W is what? Weight and P is what? Your centrifugal force, right? So when the resultant is in such a way that it passes through the center of the track, so this should pass through what? Pass through center of track. Then what will happen? Then the amount of super elevation which we have to provide is called as equilibrium super elevation or equilibrium can. So when equilibrium super elevation is provided, what will happen? The resultant force R will act perpendicular to the surface of the track. So if this is your track, it will act exactly perpendicular to the surface of the track, and hence there will be what? No lateral thrust of the rail. So if there is no lateral thrust, your rail will not get to tilt, right? So it will stay in position. So this is all about your super elevation. Now we will see what are the objectives of providing the super elevation. So now let us study the objectives of providing the super elevation. Okay, so there are basically three objectives, and each objective will result in something. So let us see one by one. So the first objective is, in order to introduce the centrifugal force, we know that when the frame is moving in a curved fashion, a centrifugal force is developed which will pull the moving train towards what? The outer rail, right? Now in order to counteract this tendency, we will introduce the super elevation. So to actually write, it is what? To introduce the centripetal force to counteract what? To counteract the tendency of the centrifugal force. This centrifugal force will do what? Will try to pull your moving train towards your outer rail. So in order to counteract that, train the position, we have to give the super elevation. Now this will result in what? Means the development of centripetal force will result in what is the next thing what we have to see. So it will result in three things. One is the faster movement of the train. So whenever the train is moving on the curve track, because of giving of super elevation, what will happen? Trains can move with a proper speed even on curves. Okay, that is the first thing which will happen. Second thing, what will happen? If the super elevation is not provided, what will happen? There will be derailment of the trains. So in order to prevent the derailment, we have to introduce the super elevation. Okay, so the preventing derailment of train. That is the second result. The third result is what? It will reduce the side wear of rails and creeps. We know that whenever a train is moving on the curved portion, there will be side wear, right? Because the pressure on the outer rail is more when compared to the inner rail. So in order to avoid that, what can we do? We can provide the super elevation, and this will result in the reduction in the side wear of rail. Also creep also will be reduced. So we have already seen what is creep, what is side wear and all in the previous sessions, right? So this is the first objective. Moving on to the second objective. So the second objective is to provide equal distribution of wheel load. So we know that on the outer rail more pressure will be there, on the inner rail less pressure will be there when the train is moving on the curved track, right? Now, in order to provide equal distribution on both the rails, what we have to do? We have to give the super elevation. So, to provide equal distribution of the loads on the rail, so that there is no tendency of the track to move out of position, right? Now, what will this result in? This equal distribution of wheel load will result in two things. The first one is what? It will again reduce the wear that is occurring at the top of the rail. So reduction in the top wear of the rail. So that will happen. And the second thing what will happen is we can save in the maintenance cost. So if the outer rail is having more wear, we have to do the maintenance, right? But if equal distribution of load happens, then the maintenance cost also will automatically reduce because both will have equal distribution. So that are the results of providing equal distribution of weight loads. Now, moving on to the last objective, the third objective of providing the super elevation is to provide smooth working of the track. So, basically, finally, the track should be smooth, safe to move and smooth to move. So, in order to provide the smooth working of the track, what we have to do? We have to do the super elevation. Now, this will result in comfort to the passengers, right? Whoever is traveling in the train, for them, it will be a comfortable journey. And also, it will have a safe movement of goods. Green ones are the results of providing these things in the super elevation. Now, let us go ahead and see what are the advantages of providing super elevation. Now, you already know, based on the objectives only, your advantages will come. But if you want to list them in order, there are four main objectives. So, four main advantages of providing the super elevation. Let us see one by one what are those. Okay, the first advantage is it will allow the trains to move in high speed on the curved track without any derailment. So, super elevation will do what? It will permit running of trains at high speed on the curved track without derailment. So, whenever we speak of super elevation, it is always on the curved track, right? So, second thing is it will reduce the wear and creep that will occur to the rail on the curved track. So, reduces wear and creep on the curved track. That is the second advantage. The third advantage is what? It will also reduce the wear of rolling stock. That is nothing but the train and the equipment which are moving on to that. So, basically, it will have low maintenance cost. So, saving, we can write it as saving of maintenance cost. That is an advantage of providing super elevation. And the fourth and the major advantage is, again, comfort and safety of the passenger when they are moving on the curved track. So, comfort and safety of passengers and goods, we can say. So, these are the four major advantages of your super elevation. So, hope this lesson is clear to you. What all we studied in this? What is super elevation? What are the objectives of super elevation? And what each objective will result in? We have seen, and then we have seen the advantages of super elevation. Thank you.